this is from the Competent Communicators Manual, which is the first manual we work through in Toastmasters for our guests this evening. Although it is her fourth speech, we decided based on her topic and the outline of her speech that it best fit project number 9, Persuade with Power. You see, Nancy's speech is what we call a back pocket speech, meaning she had little to no preparation prior to meeting this prior to giving this speech, and it is my distinct honor to evaluate her, since impromptu speaking is, in fact, my favorite type of speech to give. For the guests in the room, 8 of my first 10 competent communication speeches were impromptu, meaning that between walking in the door at 6:45 and getting up to the podium shortly after 7, that was the amount of time I had to prepare the speech. So I love impromptu speaking, and I'm super excited. I was also Nancy's grammarian, since this evening we were short of staff, and she could not grammarian critique herself. So the first part of my evaluation will be on the grammar. You used flummoxed once, extra points for that, and I caught no filler words. So bravo, Nancy. That's something I've seen you diminish from your first speech to the fourth. You're down to 0, and I didn't catch any last speech either. I was looking at my notes. So wonderful. In her speech, she's supposed to either convince us of something or call us to action or both. And I think Nancy did that. She brought our attention in with a really strong introduction, and she coupled that with a personal story about her own relationship with money. She very carefully described in a relatable, digestible, and just really detailed description of each of the different archetypes. If you're not familiar with them, she brought in some excellent resources and sources of facts for us by some reliable sources of financial wisdom. She used unexpected humor throughout her speech. Stormy Daniels, the Bed Bath & Beyond story, and the towels. Well done. Every one of us knew a person that fit within each of those categories. Your vocal variety and your body language was excellent during your description of each of those archetypes. That's a hard word to say. So bravo for not messing it up. The only improvement is I felt your clothes felt a bit short. And I'm not sure if that's because you got a red card because I was so into your speech I wasn't watching the cards. But I felt like you could evaluate a little bit further on the incompatibility of certain archetypes and maybe bump that speech up a minute to accommodate that. Other than that, I thought it was a fantastic presentation. I really